Hello, I'm back basically for part three of this tutorial. So last three where you left off, we did the actual closing suit right here. So now what I'm going to be doing right here is I'm going to be doing, let's say, the actual wand right here and the accessories that goes right here on this thing. So one thing I'm going to do is go into here. And accessories. So I'm just going to go into here. So, go into here, select this. So, just going to go into here, and I'm just going to go into here and hardness down 80, capacity around 15, and set down the first color. And you're right, I'm just going to go into here. Like that. then that's one other website I did so far. So at this level, I might, you're right, go down here. And you're right, like, start working on this. Just go into here. That way I just put that layer down. I never really have any luck with that anyways. No, I don't really have any luck. I was never really popular around the girls. You know what it is? Sorry. So what I'm doing right here is I'm kind of adding my textures right here, and I'm kind of like doing a texture map on this thing and kind of texture mapping this thing right here and adding texture map on this thing right here. So the texture mapping I'm adding, you're right, is right here on this thing right here, and that's what I'm doing. So I'm kind of adding a layer of texturing, so, and kind of like hitting the alt key of blending this stuff too as well. So that's what I'm kind of doing right now. So this is what I'm doing right now, I would say. And so what I'm going to be doing right here is adding the second layer of color, which I'm gonna probably end up, you're right, working on this. Going into here. And that's what I'm doing right there. And I guess kind of like I can take like this. Yellow symbol right here. And on the very, very top. High lines right here. And what I can basically do is kind of add layers on top where I can edit this and kind of add the highlights on there. Put that there. Sorry about that, I might have to repause this. Sorry about that, I might have to repause this and save this and repause this thing and change the actual software to a different software. But I'm gonna actually end up pausing this entire thing and saving it on a different layer. So I'm sorry about this. This is giving me trouble, so I'm gonna start pausing this and restart this software again. So stay tuned. I'm actually back and back for a digital painting tutorial. So the program was giving me some trouble, so I had to re-app it up a little bit. So I'm just gonna go into here and go duplicate. And put that at overlay. And put this at overlay. Duplicate right here. Put that at overlay right here. And you're right, I'm just gonna probably put this at and go into filter, blur, glossy and blur. Duplicate. Normal. And that's the thing I have already to use. Normal. So that's already done. So the whip is already done. So I'm just gonna take a break, and so next tutorial we're gonna seriously work on with this next is gonna be the cigarette actually what we're going to be working on next is a handcuff on here. The silver piece is going to go right here. That's going to go right here. And then the thing we're going to work on is the watch and the cigarette and getting the cigarette out of the way, basically, definitely for sure. We're sure going to add a series of different smoking techniques on there to get it in a certain way, and that's it pretty much. And just basically save the thing itself, pretty much. Same. That's, I guess, it. So I'm gonna take a little break, and I'm gonna start working on the handcuffs and the necklace, and then the next break would taking a break from there is start working on a watch and a cigarette. So see you later on a break. Hello, hello, I'm back from the break. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be working on this necklace. So I'm gonna be going into here and selecting this color. Going to be selecting swatches. So I'm just going to bring that to 80. And you just spray a whole bunch of layer like that. Just go in here. Just go into brush settings, and you're right. I'm probably gonna lower that down to 15. So we have the first layer like that. So on this layer, so that was very fast, I would say. So on this layer, we're gonna put this at multiply. Just doing digital art, I would say. Right here. Doing the scales on this thing itself. So at that rate, I'm gonna be doing, you're right, a new layer. I'm calling this and just like kind of just like do the highlights on this thing. I'm sorry I've not been talking too much. I'm just like right deep into my concentration. And this is really early in the morning. So I'm trying to get this all done so I can show you people what I can do with this. That's what I would do. And then what I would do is kind of put this ad overlay like right there and start putting those ad overlay and go into here and go duplicate like that. And you're right, go into here and go duplicate again like that. And that gives it that shiny look right there, like it's like gold metallic. So I use like kind of like a very 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 light pinkish red, whitish pinkish red, and then I put that overlay, and that's what it looks like. It looks exactly like that at the end, and I just put the layer blending mode to overlay and duplicate that a couple of times. So that's under a layer right there. So when I'm editing it, so that's all done. So now what we need to do is start focusing on the handcuffs. And the handcuffs, what we're gonna do is like, we're gonna actually do another layer blending mode for like that. That. So I put the layer swatches right there, and then what are we gonna do? We're gonna actually go into here and start going with the darker color, which is just like kind of like a medium dark color like that. And we're gonna set the brush property to, let's say, like around 50. And just lay down, you're right, a dark, sophisticated stroke like that. That covers that up. And think that's good. It's kind of like a gradient in a way. And then we're gonna raise up the property like that. Raise up the brush size to, let's say, around 40, like that. Good enough. And we're gonna do a second layer on top and take this. But first of all, we gotta bring that down to 15. Light pressure like that, with the thing like that. It's very light pressure. I think that's good. Like that. And then basically, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go on top right here from right here. Should lower down the size like that, but that's okay. And you're right, we would draw the lines where this is gonna go. Kind of like pressing a space bar and Alt key to rotate around. It's like one of those shortcuts that's in a lot of programs is a space bar and Alt key. I mean, is the Alt key is also used for the eyedropper. So you can pick a color from the Alt key like that. Very, very useful, sophisticated tool to get the job done, pretty much. And that's what I would do right here. Just like kind of like add darker layers of colors like that, I would say. Just go into here and go overlay basically right here, I would say. Right here, I would say, and add overlay, I would say, into here. And just add the light source right here. Right here, I would say. At that rate, after doing that, we're just going to go into here and go into here and go overlay like that and just hit duplicate like that. Maybe one more layer of duplicate like that to give it that shine look right there. So that's already done like that. So now the only thing we need to work on with this layer is, to be honest, is the watch and the cigarette butt. So I'm probably gonna get started with the cigarette butt. I would say. So I'm probably gonna go into here. Just hit multiply right here. And so now we're done that. So I'm just going to go in here to select. So I'm just going to place this right here. So we had that cigarette butt already done, so a lot of work. It's a lot of work to do this. Gonna go here. So, just gonna go deselect right here, and that's the cigarette butt right there. And then I'm gonna go into here and so with this, we're just gonna go like a darker color like this. And you're right, I'm just gonna go into here and make this fast and straightforward. So And multiply so that's what the actual drawing actually looks like right now so far. So we have that all done. So the next thing what we're going to be doing on, which is part like I think like part like I think 4 of the tutorial of the character modeling is the eyes, the lips, and like the nails, I think. And then part the very last one, which is part 5, is start working on the hair of the character and getting the hair down packed and ready to use for the character itself. That's what we would have right there. So that's what we, you're right, we would have right there, and that's the character, you're right, we have, I would say. Right there. And so far that's what our character, you're right, looks like so far. So that's what we have, and that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope we can I can help you out a whole lot. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Please give me likes if you like. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please give me likes and please give me watches and subscribe. Thank you. Goodbye. Base.
Bass.